Greetings and salutations, YouTube. Back with another episode of our Pokemon Scarlet Nuzlocke, as we have a Citadel here dancing around in the background. He is a very happy boy. I think if we have anything happen to any of our mons, we may have to add our Citadel to the party, because he's just a very, very happy boy. It's been a few days since I recorded. I've been a little sick. Nothing crazy, just like a cold. I've had a kind of a scratchy throat, and you know, that kind of stuff. But I feel a lot better now, and like I can actually get through a recording without seriously. Go away, Sneasel. Without seriously coughing. So, Elizabeth. The Dragon Painter. Altaria. Yeah, I'm not real big on this matchup. Oh, this is the first time we've seen Gorgonical in battle. He looks like something from Minecraft. I don't know what specifically from Minecraft, because I'm not much of a Minecraft player. But on top of the whole me being a little sick thing, Hogwarts Legacy also came out, and so I've been playing it a lot. And that is a lot of fun. That may... Oh, those are Grievards. Okay. That may be... You know, I'm not gonna promise anything, obviously, but that may be something that we end up doing on the channel. You know, it'd be pretty neat doing a... something different from what I'm doing with my character right now, because there are some choices that you can make, and obviously you've got the four houses and stuff like that, so it's a little different, and I am a Slytherin on mine right now, because I am a Slytherin in real life. Although I feel like the way everyone perceives me is like the opposite of that. Where is this taking us? Montanivera. I think that's where we need to go. Oh, we got a rare bone up on the mountain. Xavier. And he's been looking for us. Got something he's supposed to deliver. Our hands only. Skyrim reference for the uninitiated. Also, Venomoth is getting some terrible, terrible matchups, and I really want to use Venomoth. Gen 1 had some... There's a lot of stuff from Gen 1... Okay. I should have just stayed in. Wait, what? Oh, I thought he stayed in. I was like, what? Alright, Talonflame is fine. Bird versus bird. You know what they say about the bird. Bird is in fact the word. And in this instance, our bird is most definitely the word. Is he gonna go all electric on him? So yeah, now you see how terrible it works. It's not an electric type move. And physical. So this I love that it actually changes the way it looks in battle. That's fantastic. Yeah, your Staraptor just wasn't it, guy. Do I want to learn Aerial Ace? No, I'd rather have Acrobatics, I think. rather have close combat than cross chop. But we wouldn't do anything like we probably wouldn't start a playthrough of Hogwarts Legacy until after this is finished, because this is going to be a pretty long playthrough. I think we are probably closing in on 20 episodes. I have no idea what type this is. It might maybe be... It's not fighting types. Oh, it's a Zorua. Or a Zoroark. Oh, it flinched. Oh, that is the water type Tauros, but I don't know for sure what the secondary type is, or if it has one. Miss Magus. I don't know why I'm thinking about this. I've got an answer for Miss Magus. The last time I fought a Miss Magus, it took away two of my Pokemon. Of course, if we had this team at the time, it wouldn't have been an issue. Annihilape is right-handed. That's weird. He switched handedness. I'm gonna go into Serena because this thing is going to be...
It's water type, I know that for sure.
And you could tell because, one, the horns are different, but as far as a water type, there are, like, little blue diamonds on the bottom of its, like, mane thing. So I'm pretty sure this is water type. That was a waste of a move. Yep, water type. Because there are three different types of Tauros in this. In Paldea. We're actually getting pretty solid experience from these battles. Yeah, stuff to do, lady. I definitely wanted to be here. Billy Bird. And this is great. What's this? Max Ether. That's your spot, huh? Lady, it is way too cold up here to be camping. Interrupt. Well,
Venoma. Oh man,
that's interesting. This Camerupt is level 41. Okay, I gotta check and make sure I'm going the right direction. Because I may be going towards the ice gym instead of... No, because the ghost gym is 42. That's its type, or that's its level. So I probably am going the right direction. I'm just woefully underleveled. Dene. Well, Tinder would work because it's an electric type. This gym battle coming up could be pretty tough. God, I need Sludge Bomb. Breaking the mold. Psycho stuff. Good kill. Okay, his attack fell though. I don't think that a crit psycho cut would have killed, but it might have been close. Okay, Annihilip is level 40. Which is really the most important. auto heal, and you need to wake up. More trainers? Those tunnels. Delibird. They're like protecting Santa. Hey, there's a trainer. There's a bunch of Sneasels. It's only level 36, I'm gonna try taking it on. Why on earth would you go for Giga Drain? I didn't really mean to go for Sliver Dance, but... Remember if... Okay. Ghost does resist, but I wasn't positive. It is still absolutely wild to me that they gave Venomoth Air Slash by level up, but did not give it Sludge Bomb. I mean... Dunsparce. It's not as bad as... Should I stay in? Oh, he's got the long boy. I think. Yeah, I think that's the long boy. I mean, Venomoth's moveset has gotten better, but there were a lot of Gen 1 Pokemon that they gave absolute trash movesets to, and that's why they, like, Venomoth is terrible, Sandslash has always had a bad moveset, Flareon's was really, really bad for a long time. I mean, there's a reason Flareon is the worst evolution, competitively, anyway. we are definitely in the right tempo. Okay, what on earth was that? I need to know. Covert cloak. The city cloak conceals the holder, tricking the eyes of its enemies and protecting it for the additional effects of moves. That's neat. That is... this is Glaciado Mountain. Do we have a... oh yeah, we do. That's where we just were. I need to get some grinding in. I could just battle a bunch of Sneasels. This is not going to be an easy gym to take on. I was really worried that he was going to hit me with this very, very powerful. Present, the one that does like 400 damage or something. Nope. Don't need Stealth Rock. Actually, it doesn't do that much, but it does do like 150. Oh, well. Might as well battle this Sneasel. Although I am rather low on HP. I feel like Golduck or Psyduck will make sense to be up here. Unclaw. I feel like these Sneasels remind me like when you're playing 2K and you're going for the courts in the park, you know, and these dudes are just lined up waiting to like get next. That's really not a ton of HP or of experience for that. Do the Glaciado Gym to Montes Nevera. Maybe that's the direction I'm headed. Gonna keep going this way until I find more trainers. You little Pepchu, go away. Don't want to deal with you. Gosh, 3 gem badges? Oh, this thing is a fighting type, I forgot. I was about to say, this isn't a fighting type, and then I remembered, yes it is. Thank you. Actually, I miss having a good water type.
Pretty sure I have more badges than you. Yeah, I know I do. I've got 5.
We really haven't seen a whole lot of Red Hood. Because I didn't want to use it until it evolved. Trainers. Oh, how many more? This probably isn't going to be a super long episode. Because my... snow. Kind of starting to... feel a little scratchy in my throat. Ooh, Hunter. Careful there, young one. The sea turtles are so nice. I don't know why I'm surprised. I know Dragonair gets Aqua Tail. Well, I don't know why you elected for that. You're just choosing to make everything way harder than it needs to be. Frostlass. It's so weird seeing some, like, okay, because Frostlass, you know, is a stone evolution. So it's really weird to me seeing stuff that evolves with, like, stones and stuff. That's why, like, the Eeveelutions, seeing them out in the wild is just bizarre. Wish we were in the middle of a freaking blizzard. North Province, Area 1. Well, that thing was my first encounter here. So, I need to be better prepared for this. Oh, geez. Come here. I hope this thing's not gonna body me. What level is it? Oh my god! 51. Never mind. We're not prepared. We will come back for this encounter. GTFO. Sorry. There's copperages somewhere. That'd be cool. So, just got the hairy mama. There's a copper rusher right there. Glaceon. Yeah, I think I'll switch Pokemon. Oh my god, that did nothing. Redhead really needs a good fire move. Of course, the problem is the only good, like, fire or flying moves that Talonflame gets are Flare Blitz and Brave Bird, both of which are self-damaging moves. Sense. It needs like a move called like Flame Wing or something like that. I feel like it deserves a. I feel like it deserves a signature move. Or if they don't want to make it a signature move, give it to Charizard too. They love them some Charizard. I wish I had a waterfall on Espeon.
I don't have a good answer for Espeon.
I can't really switch in with Annihilate. It's. Oh my gosh, Earthquake. Yes, thank you. Just changed the game. Umbreon.
You got this, Cinnabon.
Hit him with that bug buzz. Yo. I didn't kill because I ran out of shit. Hey, Annihilate is level 41. We need him to be strong. He's the dude. I don't know what these Terra Shards do, if I'm being completely honest. Steak. Okay. That's fun. Oh. Ooh, okay. Man out here yodeling. Alright, I think this guy looks really weird. Oh, and I've got the perfect thing for you, sir. The gift. Just for you.
I think this will probably be the last battle we have.
And then we'll call it an episode. We've actually got 30 minutes of episode here. That's not bad. U-turn. Why? Moth and no, you don't need Zen Headbutt. They're trying to make him a physical attacker so bad. Who are you? Wait a minute. Who are you? Grumpig, Spoink, X Attack. Is this just green grass? What is this? Is this still Glaciado Mountain? I guess so. Okay, one more battle. You're gonna blow everyone away when you take this earthquake to the face. Take that, kid.
Cool, Watchful.
Yup, got an answer. It's the oldest member of our team. go for an electric move. Would have actually done something. We're pretty close. I think one more battle would actually get us up to the levels we need. What do you mean I can't ride? Okay. I stepped on a stone. Wait a minute. Hold on a second. This gnome might be shiny. I'm not gonna freak you out yet because I'm really not positive. No, it's not. Okay. Never mind. It's just the color is off. Like a lot. Yeah, 'cause shiny snow is pink. Alright. I don't know, I just thought it was more like white or clear. Battle. There's also an interesting set of ruins back here. Ruined. She's back here waiting to just absolutely body somebody. Body press. Oh, there's a hypno over here. I don't like that. What is with these, like, hypnos and, drowsies hanging out by ruins? We've pretty much got every item they have to offer. I was not expecting this kid to just roll up with an Arcanine. Gotta actually heal up for this. I was expecting something dumb like a Teddy Ursa or something like that, but no, he's got an Arcanine. Ooh, bobbing and weaving. Didn't kill because I don't assignment. Minus one. Arcanine looks badass in this game. I mean, he does anyway. Arcanine is such a solid Pokemon. You know, there's a lot of people that hate on Gen 1 because they talk about how, oh, there's, you know, some really stupid designs in there, so it's so basic and all of that, but like, there are some mods in there that are legitimately really cool. Blastoise. Oh my god. That did a lot. Blastoise, Venusaur, Venomoth, Alakazam, Gengar, Arcanine, Ninetales, the Legendary Birds, Mewtwo, Colossal. What is with this kid, man? Why do you have such a powerful team? Arcanine, Copperajah, and Colossal. I mean, Whiscash kind of bodies them, but... Oh, yeah, that was a little late for that, sir. And I'm not switching out. I mean, all you're doing essentially is just using all of my earthquakes, but... How did that not kill? I know I'm at minus one, but that was quite effective. He's going for the sweep. You son of a bitch. You son of a bitch. But he's gonna get the Agent Power boost now. And you know, if I would have gone for the Aqua Tail and it not killed, that Colossal could have actually been a problem. Assuming it's got that, the whatever ability it is. I can't remember what it's called now. The one that gives it boost when it gets hit by water type moves. I can't think of what it's called now. It doesn't really matter, but... off a passage. I have one encounter in Dallas off a passage. I think that's all I can get. A little more respect, please. R-E-S-P-E-C-T. Find out what it means to me. There you go. You thick fat is where it's at. You say that as a chubby man. Oh, okay, I'm glad that he recognizes that he himself is fat. Kicked. Well, Tinder, you can't deal with this one, sir. Oh, Cacturn and all your weaknesses. This is weak to bug, flying, ice, fire, fighting, fairy, and something else, I think. Oh, poison. It's got seven weaknesses and one quad weakness. Fun fact about quad weaknesses. Did you know that in red and blue and yellow, Paris and Parasect were actually quad weak, or actually had three quad weaknesses, because the game got coded wrong. So, poison was super effective on bug. So yeah, in Gen 1, there were two mods with three quad weaknesses. Just poison, fire, and flying. I mean, Charizard already bodied the poor thing. Alright, well. that, as the kids say, is that. I said this would be a shorter episode. It was not. You're welcome. I don't need any more rare bones. My bone is rare enough. Fake tears. There's an item down there. Any items? I gotta... Okay, let us... Should I jump? That was such a high fall. Oh, actually, yeah, 5 badges. That's what I said. So it seemed to be 6. I don't actually know. I think the next thing after that is the... It's the... Ice Gem, or the Ghost Gem, then the Ground Titan. And then... Oh, the psychic gem. So odd. Gotta go way out of the way to get there. But that would give it. That'll give us new encounters, I think. Yep, because that'll be South Province, Area 6, and then Alfornada Cavern, I think. But we are ready to go. Basically, the mods we're going to be relying on for this gym are Annihilate, and I guess we can really use any of them. Technically, Annihilate is the only one with a weakness to Ghost, but he's also the only one that does super effective damage. Morton's just takes reduced damage because of Purifying Salt, or whatever its ability is. That's going to be it. I'll see you guys in the next one. This is Friar Chuck saying... Bye-bye.